Yo ho, yo ho, a pirate's life for me. We pillage, we plunder, we raid, we bend, raid up, ray holly jo ho. Yo we follow, we raid, we bend, raid up, ray holly jo ho. Yo ho, yo ho, a pirate's life for me.
And drink all the rum. Sing it to the whole crew. That's my favorite ride at Disney.
It was me growing up before the films. It was still my favorite ride at Disney.
Yeah.
It's the most immersive, awesome. That's the cool thing about Disney rides, is like Disney itself is immersive. When you walk into Disneyland, it was designed specifically so that you can't see the outside world. Mm-hmm. And every ride, the ride begins before you're even on the ride. When you're in line, the ride begins. It's awesome.
They used to sell slave women on it.
Yes, they did.
And they changed.
Wenches.
Juice!
Hey, welcome back to our stupid reactions. It's up, Corbin.
I'm Rick.
And you follow us on Instagram.
Instagram and Twitter are my favorite place to fart.
Oh my god. You ready for poo?
Yeah, bring it on.
We're doing a scene from KG3.
I knew when you said that, what you were referring to.
So this is, I believe...
So we're getting ready. We're getting ready. We're ready for it now.
Pooh's introduction scene. Okay. And so obviously by the time you see this on YouTube, we've watched
DDLJ.
And now
Coochie Coochie Hachi Ho.
Yeah, well, Coochie Coochie, whatever.
Yeah, Coochie Coochie.
And I believe KG3 is the next one after that. But this is, Pooh is played by Kareena Kapoor.
Which, by the way, if you didn't see me say it, when did I say it? Were we reviewing? I think we were reviewing Cooch Cooch when I mentioned I rewatched the You Are My Sunia.
Yeah.
And realized I was in a bad headspace or whatever that day, that I actually really liked the video. And my apologies to everybody,
but
that I, for some reason, was in an off place that day.
We know the reputation of Pooh.
Yes.
Once again, funny name. It's an iconic character from this, played by her, but this is what the comment, the notes say. Here's your first step into the process of getting into KG3. I don't want to read that, blah, 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 blah. Pooh, played by Kareena Kapoor.
Right.
And her, her domestic help. The highlight of the snippet is definitely the introduction of Pooh, mm-hmm. which became a rage overnight. Consequently, the image of being the superficial bimbo got stuck with Kareena for years to come before she could break out of it through movies like Jab We Met and Omkara. Mm. After watching this, decide for yourself whether you're ready to watch the movie. Though, I must mention, Kareena has very little screen time in this movie. The song with Hrithik and Kareena is in the college setting that cringed the shit out of you all.
That song comes right after this scene.
Comes right after this scene.
Got it.
So this is her introduction. So put yourself in basically
the Grease.
Coochie Coochie and DDLJ.
Exactly.
Mindset.
Exactly.
I'm guessing that's what we're going to get in this, but I'm excited.
And the dumb bimbo thing. You know who that happened to? An actress here who was typecast for the rest of her life, Suzanne Summers on Three's Company. Mm. She played Chrissy, and it was the stereotypical dumb blonde. Really adorable character, but she couldn't be... Another person who had a really hard time and was actually a very talented actress was Farrah Fawcett. Mm. It took her almost 20 years to get out of the blonde bombshell stereotype.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Here we go.
It's like Cameron Diaz in Charlie's Angels.
This might be cut up a little bit, by the way.
Yeah.
That's a copyrighted song.
If you're wondering what's going on with the sound.
Oh, man. Oh, God. Is she white?
job making. You.
Just music behind her every single time.
Morning, dear.
Morning.
Just singing fat free.
You scared me. Piece of paper.
Okay. I'll be late. Gym class.
Yeah. Take a chill pill. I felt that coming.
Just talking to herself.
How are you this morning?
Okay.
That's
a Finger.
B-I-T-C-H-I-N-O.
I bet it's rhythmic behind her. Turn and look at the Maserati. Absolutely can.
Who is he?
Honestly, not as bad as I thought.
I'm in.
Yeah, like, I think there was actually worse stuff in Coochie Coochie in the beginning parts in terms of like the way college kids acted.
I really think, okay, absolutely. If we had been shown this early on, we would have just like probably just written it off.
Yeah.
But in the same way, like this is not, I'm not comparing it, but when I'm ready to watch The Three Stooges, I'm in a certain mindset and I'm watching The Three Stooges. And I feel like this is the exact same kind of thing, that you're in the mindset of it, and it's even way bigger than those other two. This is about as stupid, over the top, ridiculous.
Yeah.
Like, woo, fat freak.
I think
we're gonna laugh a lot.
Well, at her part specifically, I know, because she's the, because I know this film, it's Karan Johar. Or Karan. What did I say? I think it's
Karan.
Karan
Johar.
And so I know it's known for
Karan. No, it's Coffin with Karan. Karan Johar.
Flipping genres a lot.
Right.
So I've heard this one's extremely melodramatic, but also has these parts in it. And like, so I think you're going to get a whole bunch from this film.
I'm ready.
Which, like I said, I'm pretty sure at the first half of Coochie Coochie, when they're in the college realm, there was some worse scenes than that was.
Oh yeah,
just that was at least funny.
Just the basketball match between SRK and Kajol was just brutal.
Mom, take a so cheesy.
So bad.
Because obviously we watched that behind the scenes with
Karan.
I bet he feels the same way about some of those lines.
Oh, I bet even more.
Yeah.
I bet even more.
I do love that line, and I want to use the, oh, you're such a B-I-T-C-H. I know.
Yeah.
I'm going to use that.
I'm absolutely, and yes, I can feel the song coming on.
Oh, 100%.
100% can feel the song coming on.
Yeah. That one was,
And yes, the Pink Ladies, you called it.
Yeah, they're
very
they're,
Pink
well,
Ladies.
Well, that or the what are they, Mean Girls? Are they the Plastic? No, that's is the Plastics Mean Girls, or is that Legally Blonde?
Oh, I haven't seen Legally Blonde.
Oh, I think it might be Mean Girls.
But yeah. Ba-ba-da, ba-ba-da, ba-da-ba-da-ba.
Yeah.
Pink Ladies.
Yeah, I think they, like, in...
I'm trying to think, this reminded me of something else too that's just insanely stupidly over the top, and you love it.
Mean Girls, because that's playing to all the stereotypes of, because it's Tina Fey, it's playing to all the stereotypes of high school cliques.
Yeah, there's two other stereotypical ones. One is Valley Girl.
Yeah.
And another one that plays into stereotypes in a big way is Fast Times at Ridgemont High.
Oh yeah.
Which are just terrible films that you love.
I don't.
You don't like Fast Times?
But me and my wife, we had never seen it. And so about two, three years ago, we were like, let's watch this. We've never seen it. I heard it's hilarious. We didn't laugh once in the first hour of the entire thing.
Yeah, you know what Fast Times is for me? The first time I ever got to see a woman's breasts on a big screen. When Phoebe Cates comes out of the pool and undoes her top. When what's-his-face is fantasizing in the bathroom about her. She comes out of the pool and she undoes her top. I remember I was probably like 11 years old. I mean, live. Like, I had seen a Playboy magazine before, but to see it live on a big screen, I was just,
boobs.
Boobs. There's boobs. Then it came on to Showtime, like, 30 times in a month. 2 a.m, let's watch that scene with BBK.
Boobs. Well, we're going to watch it at some point.
Yeah.
I don't know when it'll be.
We're going to watch it.
But we will watch it. And then after that, we'll have to, because this is the one I know we'll probably watch next. But then after that, we'll have to figure out the next SRK Cajole one.
Well, how far into the deep end? It's my understanding that, like, K3G is the deep end on this kind of movie. That it doesn't get any deeper.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. We're ready. I'm ready.
Yeah.
I'm ready to go. Especially since I rewatched You Are My Sunia and now know what we're getting into.
And now it's his favorite song.
No, that's not true.